guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. I'm Surbhi and please take a moment and subscribe to my channel below because that will mean a lot to me and I come up with more such video so you will be aware of it. So yeah, today's video, by the title you all have read by now that today's video is about winter hair care routine which is for dandruff free hair. Now I know that a lot of us face that problem during winter or even normally, which is very normal, but we do need to take care of it. So you can trust natural ingredients completely which are present in your kitchen without digging a hole in your pocket. Isn't it great? It is, right? So now for getting your hair free of dandruff, you have to follow a few tips. So by the end, please stick and stay with me. So without any further ado, let's get into this video quickly and tell you the very first mask that you can use. In past, I've already done a hair care routine or what products I have used for my hair fall or something like that, but that was particularly meant for hair fall or just, in a daily time. But during winter, when we face dandruff, we need to change a little bit, there should be a little subjective change when it comes to different season. As we change our skincare routine, it is also important to change the hair care routine. So there will be again a lot of tricks and tips to you guys at the end of this video. But for now, I'm going to tell you some DIY masks and hacks that you can use for a dandruff-free hair. Now, dandruff is caused due to the dryness in your scalp, which you might not be aware. Even if your hair are, oily, your scalp is oily, it do require a better nourishment, which is important due to that cold air in the winters. Okay, so masking is the number one step that you can use. Now naturally, there are some ingredients which are present in your kitchen which you're not aware of, but they are good in to fight with the inflammation for the dandruff, for that itchy scalp, for the dry scalp, and they have some antifungal or bacterial property which is going to help you to reduce all of that issues. So the very number one is you can use lemon and honey. Okay, so what you have to do is you have to take lemon and honey, you have to mix them in any proportion according to the length of your hair. Okay, so if you have a long hair, you will need 5 to 6 spoons of honey maybe, but for my hair I just need 3 spoons, like big tablespoon of honey is good, and I squeeze half a lemon into that, and then you just have to mix it up and you need to apply it gently and massage. You have to keep that for 20 to 30 minutes, yes, good 20 to 30 minutes in your hair, and just rinse it off with mild shampoo. Now, using a mild shampoo is also important because you don't have to use lots of chemical or hard shampoo because you have used a natural ingredient and you want it to work, right? So you have to massage this for a good 15 to 20 minutes in your hair and then keep it for 20 minutes and then rinse it off with a lukewarm water, not a hot shower. The next hair mask is my absolute favorite, which I do almost every week. Yeah, every week, like once in a week or twice in a week, depending upon my mood. And that is using a curd in your hair. Now, curd, like a normal dahi, room temperature, you can use that directly on your scalp as your mask. So what you have to do is you just have to take a bowl of curd and you have to mix it like normally just and apply it all over your scalp. Now, curd is a age-old remedy, okay, for that inflammation, for dry scalp, for dandruff, and it is like it has some enzymes which not only helps you in reducing the dandruff but also makes your hair stronger and reduces your hair fall. So yeah, it is like that because I have used it and I have seen that my hair fall has also reduced and my dandruff issues has almost gone. Like it has reduced to that extent. So a good 2 to 3 months of remedy, if you will perform all of this, you will have dandruff free hair. Also, the best part about dahi, applying dahi on your scalp is that it zaps out all the excess oil and moisturizes your scalp as much as it is required for that, So it moisturizes only in a certain amount, the amount that your scalp needs, that your scalp requires, and it zaps out all the extra oil which is causing harm to your scalp. Now the third mask is again a very easy one. It is by using aloe vera gel, but you also have to take care that what kind of aloe vera gel you are using, because it should be in a very pure form. So try finding aloe vera gel, or if you have a plant, it's the best thing, okay? So you can just dig out all the aloe vera gel and you can apply it, massage it for like 10 to 15 minutes and then keep for 30 minutes and then just wash with a mild shampoo or just with a normal lukewarm water. But if you feel that there is a stickiness, which is fine, but if you feel that you don't like that greasiness, then you can use a mild shampoo. Go for the shampoo which are more on the natural side instead of chemical one, because that is going to help you in reducing your hair fall and for that dandruff. Now, the fourth one is using an apple cider vinegar. Now, I don't know how much you guys have heard about it, but apple cider vinegar has so much of benefits on your entire body, like your health, your skin, your hair. It has so much of benefits. Trust me, just Google it once about apple cider vinegar. You will be amazed, literally. I was very shocked. I was very surprised when I heard it, and it is true. So now for your hair care, what you can do is you can take apple cider vinegar, then you can mix it with normal water just to, you know, dilute it a little bit. You can use it in a spray bottle and you can just spray it all over your hair, which is going to act like a conditioner. So how you can use it, you can just wash your hair normally, like with a shampoo, with a mild shampoo or a anti-dandruff shampoo, and you can use that spray, like the apple cider vinegar plus the water one, in your hair. Keep it for like 10 minutes and then just wash it with the normal lukewarm water. You don't have to apply your shampoo again to rinse it off. You just need a normal lukewarm water. And by lukewarm water, I mean that a normal room temperature one, hot water plus your cold water, like a normal one, but not a very hot shower. So that's it for the hair mask. I hope this was very useful, because all of these ingredients I think are present in your kitchen, except for the apple cider vinegar, but that is also very cost effective. Like, it's just a one-time investment. You're gonna get a good big bottle under 400 to 300 rupees or even less, but it's a really good supplement if you want to try on with, or else if you want to just give it a try, go for the curd, lemon or honey one. It's gonna work amazingly, trust me. Now it's time for some hacks. In winters we use, like, you know, garam pani. And jab bhi hum wo garam pani se baat lete hain, we feel very refreshing and very nice. But while you wash your hair with that hot water, it is really very, very, very harmful for your scalp. The second one is applying a hair mask, which I have already told you guys. I have given you a list of 4 to 5 hair masks. So you can pick your favorite one and do whatever you want with that. And definitely do it, I think, twice a week is sufficient, because every 3 days you need to wash your hair, so you can perform it twice in a week. So it's gonna be very beneficial. The third one is use an oil treatment. Before washing your hair, a day before, you can use a good oil in your hair. And by good oil, I don't want you to invest in very big brands or something. It's just a basic coconut oil. You can use a coconut oil and mix it up with neem ka powder, or else normal neem leaves or curry leaves. Curry patta jo hota hai, you can use either neem leaves, or either you can go for the curry leaves. And all you have to do is you have to take your coconut oil, form it a little bit on your stove, okay, a very little bit, like it should not burn your hands obviously. You just have to give it a warm feel to it, and then just take the leaves and just crush them and put it into that coconut oil, mix them. If it is very hot, then keep it there for like 5 to 10 minutes, you know, just let the neem and curry infuse into that oil, and then apply that oil on your scalp. Massage it gently, you know, because massaging your scalp improves your blood circulation and helps you in a lot of ways. So nicely massage it on your scalp and keep it overnight, and then next day wash your scalp. The other tip is to use an anti-dandruff shampoo. Now, because during winter we have dandruff, you should switch to a natural shampoo and an anti-dandruff shampoo instead of, you know, just a daily basis one, because even I use 2 to 3 different shampoos on a daily basis. I use different one if I'm facing a lot of hair fall, I use a different one, and if I have a dandruff, I will switch definitely to something which is prone for that particular problem. And now the great game changer is using a microfiber towel. Now, a lot of us just use a normal towel, which is fine, but it creates a lot of friction and it is really not good for your hair, because it's gonna cause you flakiness and friction, which will, you know, increase your hair fall also. So, which is not, you know, right, because winters mein wo static wala feel hota hai, you know, bahut khade ho jate hain, baal bahut ajeeb se react karte hain. That is not for our good for our hair. So you can switch to microfiber towel. I have put a picture right here so you'll understand what I'm talking about. So switch to it. It is not very expensive, but it's a good, you know, replacement, and it's gonna keep your hair nice and never leave your hair, you know, wet and go out. Don't leave your hair like that. Dry your hair first and then move out, because you know, with that cold air, your hair is going to get prone to that dandruff. So that's it for today's video. I hope that it was very informative. It was a very short video. I was like blabbering, but pause, take your time, understand, and then choose your routine. I hope this video was really very helpful. If you have any doubts or any suggestions to give, then definitely do leave a comment below, and do not forget to subscribe below, and do follow me on Instagram. I'll come up with more videos. Bye.